We've discussed the database, we've discussed elements, and then in the library we've discussed element templates that can be used to produce multiple elements. Also in the library you'll notice something called tables. Now, I've got a table here called material properties. This is a table that I defined, and we will do that in this exercise. And when you define this table, you basically are setting up, well, just setting up a data structure that you might find convenient to use in your asset database. For example, with this particular table, what I would like to be able to do with it is to make use of it in calculations. Now, we're looking right now at the definition of the table. These are the different, there are three fields within this table: density, viscosity, and boiling point. When we look at the actual table, you can see these three, and plus a fourth that I forgot to mention, material ID. These are three different records, 1, 2, 3 here, that these three different records are different entries in the table. So this is the first entry, and it, as you can see, has an ID, density, viscosity, and boiling point. And the same for, when we look at this particular record here, it's going to have the same four attributes, or the same four items in its data structure. So each one of these will have, each item within this table, we're going to have those four properties. Now, we can make use of this within AF in calculations and in displays, etc. So, a table is one of the things we're going to be looking at during this exercise. As I mentioned earlier, there are calculations available. Calculations, something we're going to be working on when we work on this element template. So, for example, I showed you before, mass is in fact itself a calculation. That's one of the things that you're going to be expected to do during this exercise, is to create that calculation. Now, a calculation is simply going to go out and look at elements within this database, within this AF database. It's going to do certain things to those elements, certain calculations, as you can see over here in the equation side. In this case, it's a very simple one, just simple multiplication. It's going to return the value. That value is going to be an attribute of an element within AF. So as you can see, the elements that would be the inputs to this calculation can be things like density, which is, in this case, density is actually a table entry, and volume, which is a PI tag. So calculations are another feature of AF. And we'll do that in the exercise. And then finally, as I said, we're not actually going to do this in this particular exercise, but when you're finished configuring all this, you can make use of these within the PI clients. Both ProcessBook and DataLink have mechanisms to reach into the AF database and make use of those elements and the attributes in those elements. So what I'd like to do now is let's just go over and take a look at the actual problem, the actual exercise. In this exercise, what we're going to be doing is, first of all, we're going to be creating an AF database. So we'll start from scratch, no AF database. We'll create a table. We're going to create an element template with specific attributes, and then we'll create an AF element. And that's all we're going to do in this first exercise. Now, I should mention, as we do with most of our learning labs, if you prefer to look at a completed solution, then you will find a solution in the online learning lab. It's an AF database called solution_myafdbjoe. So if you want to take a look at that, see if I can switch over there. We'll just go ahead and take a look within, within the lab. If I go into the PI System Explorer under database, you'll find solution_myafdbjoe. So if you want to take a look at the solution, you're welcome to do that. But of course, we'd like you to give it a try first. Now again, as with most of our learning labs, we have an approach. And let's go through the approach. First thing we're going to do is we're going to create that new database. We're just going to call it something unique. We're going to create a table. This is a table called Material Properties. We'll go in the library to do that. These are going to be the different attributes of that table. As I said, material ID, density, viscosity, etc. In part C, we will take a look, or excuse me, we'll create an element template called Tank Template. As you can see, it's going to have these attributes right there. So the element template will have those attributes, level, volume, etc. Some of these are going to be pointers to calculations, some will be pointers to pie tags, some will be pointers to a database or to a table. We will, as a part of this exercise, we're going to be showing you how you would reach out and find columns within a table. So we're going to be looking for density where a specific material ID has been selected. We're going to configure a calculation. The mass is going to be equal to volume times density. That's what we'll be doing as that action C there. And then finally, in part D, we're going to create an element based on that element template called Tank A. And that element is where we actually put the references to the pie data. We're going to be using that, or we can then use that element in all of the different applications that support elements and attributes.